One, two, a one, two, three, four. Hi there, my name is Michael de Miranda. Welcome to this lesson about Huahuanco Havana style for beginners. I had some questions about this rhythm. I already did this rhythm, but there was no notation. And there seems to be a problem with the three part of the clavis. So I will explain it again and I hope you can follow it and that you can, in the end, you can play it too. Okay. Let's start explaining the clave. There are two parts in the clave, the three part and the two part. The three part has three notes. It's like this, one, two, three, four, two, three, four, and. So one and on the two end and on the four end. One, two, and three, four, and. And the two part has just two notes, like this, and it's on the two and the three. One, two, three, yeah? I will explain this in a 3-2 clave. So I will start with the 3 part. The 3 part, it starts with 2 slaps and a bass. The first right hand, left hand slap, and then a bass. But the first note is directly after the first beat. So if I count 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. Directly after the 1, 1. It's like this, yeah? This bass note comes exactly together with the second note of the clave. So you have one, two, three, four, katakum. Yeah? It's together, yes? After the bass, a slap with the left hand, and then you come to the tumba and play the first open tone here, yeah? So you have one, two, three, four, takatum, katum. Yeah? One, two, three, four. Again. One, two, three, four, one. The first open tone there. After this open tone, the left hand is playing a slap. And then the first open tone on the conga is coming, yeah? One, two, three, four, one. Again. One, two, three, four. Then a small rest. Then a slap again with the left hand and the second open tone on the conga. Yeah, then you have katakum, katum, katin, takin. The second open tone is just before the beat. One, two, three, four, one. Again. One, two, three, four, one. Then, only three notes are coming. The left hand is playing a slap here. Open tone again on the tumba. And a slap with the left hand here. One, two, three, four, one. This last slap is just before the first beat. Yeah, so you have katakum, katum, katin, katin, katum, ka. Just before the first beat. Then on the first beat is nothing. And then you repeat the pattern. You start exactly, directly after the first beat. Yeah? So you have this one, two, three, four, one. have the beat to it. You have 1, 2, 3, 4. Again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. Taka doom, ka do ka, ting ta ting ka do ka. Taka doom, ka do ka, ting ka ting ka do ka. Taka doom, ka do ka, ting ka ting ka do ka. This is the one again. Yeah. Now, perhaps you have noticed that this melody from this melody is in the two part of the clave, and that's the Cuban way. In Cuba, they don't play the melody together with the clave in the three part. They don't play tunka tinka tinka tunka katakum katuka tinka tinka tunka katakum. They don't play it like this. They play ta tuka tinka tinka tuka katakum katuka tinkin tuka katakum katuka tinkin tuka katakum. Like this, eh? So the melody is in the two part of the clave. Now I know that if you start this pattern, Wawanko is of course faster, and you want to start this pattern, it's not easy to start directly after the first beat. And that's why in Cuba, not only in Cuba, when you play this rhythm, lots of people, they use tricks to avoid starting directly after this first beat. So for instance, what they do is they play the first two notes of the three part of the clave, they play it here, and then after the second note, they start the melody here from the wawanko. So they play tunk tunk tunka ting ting tuka kata tunka tuka ting king. Yeah? So again, they just play the first two notes. Tunk tunk tunka ting king. And then they play it like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. And so on. Or they have other ways that you can also play. So you have do go do go. Tuka ting king tuka. Or you can just play four notes, four open tones here on the beat, just like. It's not that beautiful, but it makes it easier because the tempo is faster and it's difficult to play when the clave is. This can be difficult, so that's why they have tricks. So, and so on. Yeah? Okay, I hope you've enjoyed this lesson, and I hope you can use this rhythm, and I wish you good luck and have fun with it. See you next time. Bye bye.